What about fluorine? So 1,2-difluoroethylene. If I ask you what is the most stable conformation, what will be your answer? So in this case also, if you don't have any prior knowledge, you will say that the gauche form will be the antiform will be the stable form compared to gauche, but the answer here is reverse. Here the gauche form is the most stable conformation between these two. Now the question is why? So here we will see a very interesting interaction, and these things are the attractive part of chemistry. So this is the very fascinating part of physical organic chemistry, and later when I will discuss about anomeric effect, or you can see my other videos where I explicitly made video on anomeric effect. So this is one kind of anomeric effect. This is basically a one type of non-bonding interaction. So what is that non-bonding interaction? So if you look at the gauche form carefully, so this is our gauche form, and if you look it carefully, so this is our CH bond, right? And this CH bond we can draw like this. So here, yeah, like this. Okay, so this is basically CH sigma bond. Okay, so this is the CH sigma bond, and this CA bond we can draw the sigma star orbital of this bond. So here we have the, so this is basically the CF sigma star, and you can see this sigma and this sigma star, they are parallel to one another, right? They are parallel to one another. So from this sigma, electron can be donated to this sigma star, right? So this is basically CH sigma to CF sigma star donation. This donation is possible here because they are parallel to one another. If I draw a simple structure, I can also draw it. So like this, here you have this fluorine, here you have this CH bond. So from this CH bond, you can donate electron to this sigma star. So this is sigma star, this is sigma. This sigma sigma star donation is possible, and it is basically a kind of hyperconjugation. You can see, you can say that this hyperconjugating structure is present here. So this is a kind of hyperconjugation, but for this to happen, this CH sigma and CF sigma star, they need to be parallel to one another, and which is present only in the gauche form. But in the antiform, you can see the CF sigma. So in this case, the CF sigma and CF sigma star, they are parallel to one another, not the CH sigma and the CF sigma star. So in this case, the CH sigma and CF sigma star, they are not in the perfect alignment for this sigma to sigma star donation, which is only possible in the gauche form, and that makes this gauche form stable. And this is not only one way. So like here, another this kind of interaction is possible between this CF sigma star and this CH sigma. So two sigma sigma star interaction is present in the gauche form, and which will make the gauche form stable compared to the antiform. Now you may ask that why in case of chlorine this is not the case, or in bromine. So that there are two reasons. The first reason is, for this sigma sigma star interaction to occur, your CX, that is CX bond, means this X may be fluorine, chlorine, bromine or iodine. So this CX bond need to be more polar. More polar the bond is, that is more electronegative the X is, lower will be the energy of the sigma star. So basically you are looking at the interaction between this sigma star and this sigma. The sigma is filled, and these two molecular orbitals, they are they are combining to give a new set of molecular orbital where your two electrons are placed in a lower energy orbital compared to the previous one. So this interaction to happen in order to happen this interaction, that is the interaction between the sigma and sigma star, the energy between the sigma star and sigma should be closer. They should be close enough in energy in order to fulfill this overlap criteria, right? Now the fluorine is electronegative enough to lower the energy of this sigma star so that this sigma and sigma star can interact. But if you consider other halogens, chlorine, bromine or iodine, in their cases this sigma star will have very high energy. So let's say your sigma is here and your sigma star is here, which are very far apart from one another, and that's why there is no interaction. But in case of fluorine, the situation is very optimized and there is this interaction, and that's why this kind of effect is only possible for fluoro substituted compound, and this particular effect is called Gauche effect. So because normally we see that the molecule is more stable in the anti form, but in this case, due to this sigma sigma star interaction, the molecule is more stable in the Gauche form, and that's why it is called the Gauche effect. Another reason why it is not seen in case of chlorine, bromine and iodine is again the size of chlorine, bromine and iodine is much bigger than fluorine, and that's why in their cases steric hindrance and the coulombic repulsion, that plays a very important role to destabilizing this Gauche form. So the Gauche effect is only possible for the CF bond and not for other carbon halogen bonds. Okay.